In the January 2021 update, a thin extrude option has been added to the extrude command. While this has certainly added some flexibility to extrudes, I'm going to be slightly critical of this feature. Let me explain why. Thin extrudes exist in some form or another in many CAD programs. The basic premise is this. Instead of creating a set of four lines that defines the boundaries of a wall, we can simply sketch a single line and the extrude command automatically adds the thickness. Let's see how this has been implemented in Fusion. Let's start with a simple circle sketch. If we start the extrude command, we see the new thin extrude option here. Let's select that. Similar to a regular extrude, we need to select a profile. If we pull this up, we see a circular thin wall emerging. We can adjust the thickness. We are also able to control the direction of the thickness to be on either side of the sketch line, or with the sketch line as the center. The rest of the center extrude options are also available. Previously, without the thin extrude option, we would have to create an offset sketch in order to create such a feature. So this option will greatly simplify sketches. Let's try performing a thin extrude on an existing cylinder. Select the top face as the profile. By changing the direction of the extrude, we can perform a cut. This might be useful in creating a lip and groove feature, for example. The thin extrude option has one major limitation. You are only limited to working with closed profiles. Trying to thin extrude an open sketch line will not work. To me, this defeats the purpose of a thin feature. The whole point of having a thin feature is so that we can simply sketch lines and then use these lines to create walls. This would be especially helpful for creating heat fins, for instance. With this limitation, we can only use the thin extrude option for the very specific case of creating a thin wall around a closed border. This actually competes with the existing shell command that we already have. At the moment, we actually have two commands that somewhat fulfills the role of a thin feature. They are the rib and the web commands. Let's take a quick look at how we can create this using the web command. I have prepared the base plate with a sketch composing of a few lines on the top face. Go to Create, Web. Select the sketch lines as the curve. For depth options, choose depth. If you do not see the depth arrow, you might need to flip between the two options again. Since we need the walls to extend upwards, let's flip the direction and set a distance. Set the thickness. We can choose to extend the walls to the boundary by checking the Extend Curves option. So it looks like the web command can be a promising candidate to be used as a thin feature. However, the options are not that intuitive and not as comprehensive as what you will find in an extrude command. The web feature tends to work best for creating ribs within enclosures. So the thin extrude is in an awkward place right now. It appears to want to emulate both the shell and web commands at the same time, but does neither effectively. When I posted this concern on the official Autodesk YouTube video, I got a response from Rob Kohi, who is the Director of Product Management for Fusion 360, saying that the feature would include the use of open profiles very soon. So I guess we would have to wait and see. I am curious to know how you might be using the thin extrude option in its current state. Let me know in the comments.